organic food, one has to actually build good soil. And to build a good soil, you need to compost. You need to learn to compost. So the very simple method of composting that we learned today. So take any container, and then you have some old newspaper. Just line it at the bottom. So what are the other things that you need when you need to compost? So you collect enough dry leaves. These are available free, and there's plenty of dry leaves around the house. And then you need, that's the brown stuff. And then you have the kitchen waste. You have your fruit peels, your veggie peels, your coffee grounds, and everything that comes from your kitchen. So the one, two, and then you need an accelerator. An accelerator could be a simple buttermilk, which is a little sour. It has enough microorganisms that can kickstart your breakdown of the organic matter. Or if you can have cow dung. Cow dung is another very good organic material where you can use it for your composting. There are ready-made solutions like panchagavya and other microbes available in the market, which can also be introduced. So on the first step, we'll have to remember the four to five things we have to keep in mind. One is the dry browns, the wet greens, and then the moisture. The moisture comes from the breakdown of the wet waste itself, and then the aeration, the oxygen. Because this is an aerobic process, you need oxygen. So you need to turn the pile once in a few days, and microorganisms. That could be anything from your kitchen or store-bought. So these are the five things that you need to keep in mind. So the first step will be to also add some dry leaves at the bottom so that any excess moisture can be absorbed by them. Then take your kitchen waste. So this is not garbage. I'm touching them in hand because I consider I've just eaten them and it's still food. So we are trying to compost the food that we eat. It is not garbage anymore. It is, unless you throw it away and you don't treat it as a good resource, then we consider this as garbage. So you take dry leaves. So dry leaves also act as, they let them breathe. As this starts to break down, this compacts because there's a lot of moisture. So the dry leaves helps the pile breathe. Breathing is very important because that's where it stays aerobic and you have no issue of smell at all. So you can take any of your accelerators. This is full of microorganisms. So you can actually take a little bit of this and sprinkle on that. This just kickstarts the breakdown itself and it also accelerates the breakdown. So you can mix it up and drop it. So this is the first day. Whatever waste that you generate on one day can be dropped in. Then you cover it, make sure there are holes on the top of your lid because you don't want it to suffocate because it needs oxygen to breathe. And then the second day, you continue the same process. You again take your kitchen waste and then you add enough dry leaves and you can put some accelerator if you want. If you can get cow dung, you can probably put one of them will be fine. So you put some cow dung slurry. This is excellent. It's full of microorganisms. And then you drop it into your pipe. So now second day, again third day, fourth day. On the fifth day, you give it a turn. So that you make sure that it stays, aerated. And there is enough oxygen moving around. And again, you close. You make sure, probably you just cover on top with some dry leaves, shredded dry leaves. So that you don't, the flies don't come in. Then close it and keep it, and after say around 40 days, after you stop putting any fresh waste, you will get something like this. This is wonderful compost. It is crumbly, it's dark, it's moist, and amazing amendment to your soil where you can grow organic vegetables and your food. Please do send your questions about home composting. Subscribe to this channel and know more about gardening and composting.